Falls in seniors are, probably, the most common and dangerous things that happen. It is estimated that 1/3 of old folks over 65 years of age fall and cause bodily harm to themselves. Every 15 seconds an elderly person ends up in an emergency room in the United States. Every 29 seconds an old American dies because of a fall or complications arising from a fall. It is the fifth leading cause of death in the US. Who is at risk? An elderly who has fallen before, a person who has issues of strength, gait and balance. A person taking medication both prescribed or not, and person having serious illness such as dementia, diabetes, dizziness, arthritis, pain. The risk of falls increases as a person gets older, acquires new diseases or both. A reason to be cautious is that everyone grows old and becomes a candidate for falls. A person may be young but he/she will be old. Falls are responsible for a host of other ailments that lead to serious consequences. These can include immobility, depression, social isolation and pain. And constant visits to doctors, care facilities, dependence on family members can also be a consequence and which may necessitate living in nursing homes. This situation becomes even worse if there are second or subsequent falls and injuries. Serious diseases such as dementia, Alzheimer's disease, hip and leg fractures, serious knee and arthritis problems can occur. At present, there are many research studies conducted. And as time goes by, we will learn more. For instance, now researchers are calling Alzheimer's disease as the third diabetes. What they mean is that there is a connection between blood sugar and that disease. Possibly, there could be a connection between blood glucose and diseases in general. What is more common is falls and the whole issue of balance. Probably began a while back in the physical state of the senior. Mostly likely 10 or 20 years earlier, and the condition deteriorated as time went by. If some earlier signs of balance were addressed, earlier care and prevention would have been possible. Medical personnel who treated older people with falls use the Morse fall scale to measure fall risk factors in determining how to address improvement and care. The supervising doctor or staff reviews the patient's past history, medical history, gait, physical condition and mental status. Based on this information, he or she then makes recommendations. The Morse fall scale, MFS, is probably more important in determining the condition of the elderly and not simply the age number, because there are many 80 and 90 year seniors in better state than 70 year old or even 60 year old. What is important is that the patient or the caregiver look at possible adverse conditions in the home or elsewhere the patients frequents. They should look causes of tripping and falling and ways to correct them. These could include things like inadequate lighting, cracks or uneven floors, passageways around the home, stairs, bathrooms and bathtubs, loose rugs and other area need to be looked at. If the older person goes on walks, the roads and the conditions used should be evaluated. If there are harmful dogs and other animals found on the road. Traffic conditions, use of appropriate clothing for the weather. Communication means phones and contacts with family members and friends and others. The patient, the family members and the caregiver should make a risk factor and prevention checklist. This is personalized and will vary from person to person. While the rest of the body plays a part, patients should take care of the knees. And the role the knees play in supporting the legs, the torso and the rest of the body. The use of fall prevention devices and resources should not be underestimated. Patients should use walkers, special socks, wheelchairs, stairs, elevators installed if possible. Hand railing for bathroom and bathtubs, adjustments to sitting areas and the bedrooms. So, with regards to fall, what is the role of medicine? The science of geriatrics, the branch of medicine or social science dealing with the health and care of old people, is to help the elderly be comfortable and functional, which means personal independence. This could by exercise, medication and medical advice. In the next section, we will look at how we can address falls and balance in general. It is equally critical that elders and their caregivers consult and follow the advice given by doctors and medical care staff. While all conditions that affect the senior should be looked at and addressed, including medical advice, the onus should lie on the patient, providing that person is capable of doing that and carrying out what is recommended. We will look at ways to address physical problems in the next video, that it will be useful to that elderly person.